Greetings, folks. This is Woody from Obadiah's Wood Stoves. I've always been against going through a wall using a typical wall thimble. In many cases, you would see it done where you'd have a metal shield similar to what we have here, and it would be installed in the wall. It would be a square with a round circle, and the outside would be a T. And the pipe comes through like this, it's a 90 and comes down and goes into your stove. A lot of issues concerning that. My feelings as far as how that would work is, first off, you're going up, the smoke stops, does a 90, and then has to redirect. You have a transition where you have warm space, you have cold space. It's cold outside, it's warm inside. So you have a little equilibrium going on between those two spaces as far as temperature when the pipe's cold. Once the pipe's warm, it's not such an issue, it's just when it's cold. However, when it goes out, it hits the T, it has to do another 90 and go up. So you've done 180, you really haven't gone anywhere. So you've created all this turbulence, and you have a propensity for moisture because of condensation, because of the temperature difference of warm air going into a cold pipe. Prime example, in the summer, go outside with a glass of ice water, it sweats, you get the picture. You have wood smoke, you have more water vapor, moisture, condensation in your pipe, you will build cresote. Cresote burns at over 2,000 degrees, it's very flammable. Not such a good idea. So now you have a T on the outside, you have to go outside and you have to take the bottom of the T off and run a brush up it. That's how you clean your chimney. So, or you go from the top and down, put a bucket in the bottom of the T. This system is totally different. This is very unique. You guys are probably going, whoa, what's going on? So going through the wall like we are at an angle, we've eliminated a lot of issues. We no longer have a pipe going through the wall like this. All the cresote stays in. Any cresote that builds up in this transition runs back down into the stove and gets reburned. So we've eliminated a lot of the cresote issue. We've eliminated a lot of the turbulence because coming up out of the stove, we're simply going straight up and then hitting a 30, which you can see is a very slight offset. And this would install at the base of that on the stove. So, and then on the outside, we have another 30, and then we go straight up. Our pipe is super well insulated. Our pipe is amazing. It actually meets Canadian ULC S629, which is a very high standard. It carries the UL listing here for the US, but it also meets Canadian. So as you can see, the pipe up close, if you start really paying attention, our seams are laser welded. That's a butt joint, and it's welded together by a laser. Incredible. It's just very nice. The inside is the same way. There's your laser seam. You've got air holes to allow the moisture that builds inside, any condensation that builds in your pipe can escape. So air can flow from the bottom of the pipe through our insulation and out the top. That way we don't have any condensation buildup. Our R value stays very high. You can touch our pipe outside when it's cold. Even our T's, when they come through, you'll see snow building up on top of them. You don't see very much snow building up on any Class A pipe that I've ever seen before. So anyhow, it's being a firefighter, it's important to me that you guys are safe. And I don't want to sell products that I know are inferior. So that's why we do a lot of research and we look for other companies. You know, I'm not a pipe manufacturer by any means. I don't build this stuff. I have a company that builds it for us. And the guy started as a chimney sweep. So we've got a great product for you. I think that you really will love it. It's Woody from Obadiah's. Thank you.